I'll be showing the Whiteboard app inside of Microsoft Teams. So first off, I'm the educator in this case. I'm going to click Join to launch a meeting. Now, first off, we're going to open up the share tray in this meeting. So I'll go here and click Open Share Tray. Now, way over on the right, you might not have ever seen this, is Microsoft Whiteboard. And I'm going to click this to join and start the whiteboard. Now, the first choice I get is, do you want to present the whiteboard where only I can edit, or do you want to allow everyone to edit at once? In this case, we're going to start with just presenting the whiteboard. So as the educator, I'm just going to present this, but we'll open it up to allow other collaboration later. And I'll click Present Whiteboard. And you see there's a little pop-up that says only you can edit. If I wanted to change this, I would choose this switch to other participants can edit, yes, but for now we'll leave it off. Okay, across the top I have my toolbar, I have pens, an eraser, text box, sticky note, and we'll start with just some text boxes. So here's idealist number one, I'll create another one, idealist number two, and a third one, idealist number three. Now with the whiteboard, I can drag wherever I want. So I'm gonna drag this one over here. I'm gonna drag this one right here. And I'll drag this one over here. And I've got some pens up here. So maybe I wanna have underlined, this one is red, and idealist number two is gonna be the green list, and idealist number three is gonna be the blue list. The other thing to note is that I can pan and zoom. So if I click here in panning and zooming, I can drag things over to the left, I'm clicking and dragging over to the right, and I can also zoom way out, or I can zoom way back in, and so it's kind of that infinite canvas, which is really nice. That allows you to have your ideas to flow wherever you want on the page. Now up here in the upper right, I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna turn on other participants can edit. So some of the students like Ella and Alex and Henry, we can all collaborate together on this whiteboard. Okay, I'll turn this on, and the way we're gonna do is we're gonna collaborate for team names. So we're gonna have the red team, the green team, and the blue team, and we're gonna brainstorm sticky note ideas for the name of our project teams. Okay, everybody, let's go. Okay, we're gonna start adding notes. You can see Alex's appeared there, mine appeared. I'm gonna type the Red Rovers, and I'm gonna drag this over into my idea list number one. You can see Alex has his sticky note there. I see other sticky notes appearing. And I'll make another sticky note, and I'm gonna drag this one down here into the list. I can see the green machines is there, and I'm gonna call this one the red dragons. And maybe I wanna have a little green here on the green machine, and so I'm gonna underline, that's pretty cool. And return to the blue lagoon, that's a great one. Now what's nice is I can pan in and out, so if I wanna pinch and zoom backwards here, I can go way back and I can see what's going on. In my list, I can go around and I can come back in and I see there's some new ideas. I see Return to the Blue Lagoon was already there. I'm gonna drag this one down into the list. And then we've got Bluebird Day and a couple other ones. So you can see how easy it is to collaborate. Now, what I'm gonna do in this case is I'm going to put the board back into read-only mode. Okay, everyone, great brainstorming session here. I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna say, off. So now what it looks like on the other screens, I'm going to switch to a student, you'll see that it pops to read only. So here I am signed in as a student, and you can see that the board has been marked read only, and it says right here, it gives me little instructions, and I can just say, got it. So now I can't change the board while the educator is talking and we've done our brainstorming. Okay, now that our brainstorming is all done, I can leave the meeting. One thing to note, you can open this up in the actual Whiteboard app on Windows 10, but since this is all about the web app, I'm not gonna do that in this demo. The other thing is on the settings, you can export this whiteboard as an image, but when I end the meeting, I'm gonna show where this whiteboard shows up in the future. So I'll click End Meeting right here. Now the meeting has ended, but note right here in the meeting chat, you see files, meeting notes, and whiteboard. So this is the permanent home of that whiteboard. You see when I click that, it's always here and I can retrieve it for later. So that's where Whiteboard lives. Another thing to note is that there's going to be many, many more features added to the whiteboard in the coming future inside of Teams. So come back for more videos as we show more additions of new features in Whiteboard.